Praise the Lord. Amin na bendisyonan ko lang naman ni Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amin na ti mga sabak kapagsat. Kung hindi ni Brad Rice ng mga dawat at kumanghanda yung turuturog. Amo nga, damot mawatan niya kapagsat kay Bagana. Amen. Amin nga dati, amin nga mawatan. At damot na tayo mawatan kapagsat kung amo nga nalain kayo, amo nga at damot pinis nga mawatan niyo. So, ang kayo nga, maturog, kita ang yung kapagsat ni Jay Bagbagana at ang nagamawatan kayo. Amen. Amen. Amin sa kapagsat mo, kaya ka mo tumakdurog ng mga takap mo, at sa iyo yung sa amen. Ang muyo pa din mga kapatid, kinulong sa may sanga teknik ni Jay Bulay takap, no? Ang mga mawawatan, ang mga mangod, isa sa una. So, ag masilip tayo kapagsat mga mga ni Satanas, itakabay tayo mga buyot-buyotan ka na hindi matatayo. Amen. So, dawat ako may ni Brother Robert, mga kapatid, isa na tiyong kapatid niya tayo, ang mukadali sa gana ni Apo nga, mensahe, itong kalmais ka na tayo. So, say God bless Brother Robert.
God bless Brother Robert.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. God is worthy to be praised.
Yes, amen.
I just want to thank the pastor for giving me this opportunity. That it will stand before you today and deliver to you what the Lord put upon my heart. Good to see everybody here. I just love to see all these faces and the children. You know, in this world, there are many voices that are crying out. Each one of these voices demands to be heard. And some say this, and some say that. Some say you come this way, others say you go that way. But are these voices speaking the truth? We have to be careful for what we hear.
Amen.
Now, we'll go to my text message, text today. It's Proverbs 23:23. Proverbs 23:23.
Praise God, ti kunana di ti kapagsat iti Proverbs 23:23 kunana. Inapudno kinasirim sursurog kan na imbag anakom, maikarida apagkastuan ng napatay da unay ken di mo kayat na ilako.
In the English, it would be buy the truth and sell it not. Also wisdom and instruction and understanding. Solomon, who was the son of King David and the wisest man on earth, is saying to us, buy the truth and sell it not. John Huss, a 14th century martyr, said, seek the truth.
John Huss, 14th century,
Listen to the truth. Teach the truth. Love the truth. Live your life by the truth. And defend the truth. Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor of Judea, who sentenced Jesus to the cross, asked Jesus, "What is truth?" The word truth is found in the Bible 224 times. Now, if I can give a definition, the word truth and what it means is truth means that which is true. It does not mean that which is false. For example, 2 + 2 = 4. This is a truth. We all know it as a truth. It will always be that way. 2 + 2 never = 5. And you cannot question truth because truth is absolute. So we are to worship God in truth. John 4:23. True worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Amen. True worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. The reason true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, because the Father seeketh such to worship Him. John 4:24 says, God is a spirit.
Yes.
Right? And they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. So this also tells us there is a proper way to worship God.
Amen.
Amen.
And there is an improper way to worship God.
Praise the Lord. So ibagay na kapasat na ta iti kusto mapalagdayaw tayo kung ang dapat itihan ng kusto mapalagdayaw.
Amen.
David, King David, tells us in the Psalms that we are to worship God with the instruments, with the stringed instruments, with the tambourine, and with the cymbals. We are to worship God, right? He tells us to worship God in the songs and the dance.
And the dance with our hands raised forward.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Now all of this is true, to worship the Lord with the instruments and with the cymbals and the stringed instruments, to worship the Lord in the song and the dance. All of this is true.
Amen.
And this is the way our worship services are done. This is how we do it. We follow this model that David said to do. Everyone in here sees when we worship. But there is another kind of worship. And this is what the Lord is talking about. To worship God in spirit and in truth. All of this outward worship is great and it's wonderful. But if you don't worship God in spirit and in truth, it means nothing. Your worship of God has to come from deep within your innermost being. It has to come from your heart. It has to come from your soul. It has to come from your mind. All that is within you, all that you are inside, you have to worship God. And your worship of God must come from out of you like a fountain that is gushing upward toward heaven. Like a river that's right over here as it flows to the sea. Your worship to the Lord must be like that river flowing from you toward God. Our worship must be through the Holy Ghost Jesus said that we are to worship God in spirit and in truth. Worship must be grounded and tied in the realities of biblical revelation. Genuine worship toward Jesus Christ must never be without thought. It should never be just going through the motions. Your worship must be rooted in the truth of God and the truth of His Word to us, the Bible. True worship comes from people who are deeply emotional and who love the Lord deeply and His truth. Pilate asked Jesus, "What is truth?" Jesus said in John 17:17, as he prayed for his disciples, "Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth." Now John 1:1 says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God."
Praise the Lord. So pansinin niyo, kapag sa, so awat may amay na para sa ilubo at the
Now remember, Jesus said in John 17:17, thy word is true. So with this understanding, let's reread John 1:1. In the beginning was the truth. The word, remember Jesus said, thy word is truth. In the beginning was the truth. And the truth was with God. And the truth was God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, lived among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. The truth is, Jesus is God manifest in the flesh.
Right, amen.
Praise the Lord. Ako tayo kapagsat na ni Apo Jesus at nag-manifest, nagbalin, nagbalin nga nasagot, nagpakalasagot kapagsat.
And we are to worship the Lord from the deepest part of our being. We are to worship the Lord in the spirit and the beauty of holiness.
Amen.
If everybody will turn to Isaiah chapter 1. Verse, starting at verse 10.
Mansaan di baso dagiti imayo last verse pagbagyo sa ninyo ti amin na kinadakes ang makikitak maarami denyo pwede sardinyon ti agarami kikidakes.
So what is Isaiah talking about? What is God revealing to Isaiah? He says, I'm tired of the lambs. I'm tired of the bulls. I'm tired of the blood that's being shed. I'm tired of your offerings. God is saying, who told you to do this? And of course, you know, Isaiah is like, well, you did, Lord. You said this is what... No, God said, I didn't say to do that. I did not tell you to go and offer all the sacrifices and praise offerings and all this stuff in my temple just so you can go out and live like the devil when you walk out the temple.
Praise the Lord. So in bagani Apo Jesus in ni Isaias nakabsat nga dijay di manabasa tayo ma isardum dai kiti agiyo panunog agi daton kapuna kalpasan ti daton kapasat nga gidaton dai tu matay daton da umor da mari kag biag dai ti baso.
In order to worship God, you have to have a clean heart.
Praise the Lord.
In order to worship God, you have to have a clean spirit. And you can come to church and raise your hands, but if you've got sin in your life, guess what? God's not going to watch you raise your hands.
Amen.
He will not love, he will not watch it.
Yes. Yes.
And he knows.
Amen.
He knows. He watches us every day.
Amen.
He sees everything we do.
Yes. Hallelujah. Parang pangalaman ko yung tira. Parang pangalaman ko yung mensahe ni Aki. Parang pangalaman
ko yung tira. Hallelujah. He was telling Israel, you were offering all this stuff up according to the law of Moses.
Praise the Lord.
But you're offering it up out of because you were told to. And he's telling the church. He's telling the church. Don't come and offer your hands and praise. Don't come and worship me if your heart is unclean. Don't come and worship me if your spirit is unclean. I'm not going to watch you. And if you're offering prayers to me, I'm not going to hear you. God sees everything we do.
Amen. Makikita ni Apo itong gararamit tayo mga kapatid. Malungan tayo man ni tao, malungan tayo man ni Diyan niya, malungan tayo malungan
ni Apo. He hears everything you say.
Ako ni Apo, wala pa hindi sa utay ka kapsat. Actually, ipre-pre mo pa lang, di ba mulat mo? Ako ang better reward na niwan ko, ako ni Apo.
Amen.
And he knows the very thought you think before you even think it.
Amen.
Amen.
So we cannot hide anything from God.
Amen.
We can only come and worship God in truth, and if we live our lives by the truth of His Word.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
You cannot. You cannot go and live like everybody else out here who doesn't know the truth and expect God to pay attention to you when you come into this church. You have to come with a clean heart. Oh, create in me a clean heart, O God.
Hallelujah.
Renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, O Lord. We have to worship God with a clean and pure heart. It is said that the true believer is the only Jesus that a non-believer will ever see. In other words, you are the example of Christ. You are his representatives. You are to take this truth and apply it in your daily life.
Amen.
By doing so, the word of truth is seen by the non-believers.
Amen.
If you really want to walk with God, you will study and read from Romans to Revelation. These are the letters that are written to the churches. They are instructions on how to live in truth. Now I'm saying this to those who have been baptized. If you've been baptized, study Romans through to Revelation. If you have not been baptized in Jesus' name, start studying the gospel. Start studying the gospel. You have to read the Word of God. You have to read the Word of truth. And you have to ask God to help you apply it to your life.
Amen. Maiyaramit tayo kapagsat, itibagbagi tayo. Makita ko maitibunga, itibasbasaan tayo, mga kapatid.
We are to love the truth. We've already established that God is the truth. We already established that Jesus is the truth. And we've established that Jesus is God.
Praise the Lord. Ang magpakabsat na ay ayatin tayo si kinapunod.
Deuteronomy 6:5. In English it says, And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thine heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy might. That means everything you have within you, you love the Lord.
Amen.
We are instructed by the truth of God to love the Lord our God with all that is within us. You love the Lord because He first loved you.
Amen.
You love the Lord because He loved you so much that He purchased you from sin and death by going to the cross and giving His life so that you wouldn't have to spend eternity in a devil's hell. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Love Him because He wants us to live with Him.
Praise the Lord. So ayat din tayo iti ako mapagsak na po katakirag kay gagay na at makaduwa na tayo.
And He wants to have fellowship with us.
Din kaya na mapagsak na madan na yung kumaiti fellowship. Panagbuti na yung may sa Kanya na mapagsak.
We love our Lord for what He has said and done and what He's going to do. By loving Jesus, we love the truth. And we are highly encouraged to love the truth. Second Thessalonians chapter 2, starting at verse 5. Second Thessalonians chapter 2, starting at verse 5.
Iti Ilocano kakabsat tunana ditoy di kayo malagit nga idiadda at palaeng kada kayo impagpagat kada kayo dagitoy agang bagay.
All the way to verse 1.
Verse 5 to 12. Yeah. Ket ita amuyo timang tiped ken kuana tapno may paranarang iken kuna. Katipalimed, tikinadakes agar arami din. Uso na laing at daita, mangigawid, agingga, iti isulti, maikat iti tinga. Ket iti kasta, may parangarang tun, iti natangkes, isu apapatayan tun ni Apo. Jesus, babaen ti Espiritu, tiniwat na, ket pukawen ng to babaen, iti rangrang tiya ay na. Dayjay, nga itiyaay nakas iti panangaramid ni Satanas ama pakuyugan iti amin apan nakabalin ken dagiti pangilasinan ken dagiti ulbo at datlag ken ti amin nga lilaw ti kinadakes ama ipaay kadagiti mapukaw ang sikop dadida inayat inawat Ti ayat ti kinapudno a maipaay kuma apan ti salakanan da. Ket gapo ituy ti Dios ipawit na kadakwada ti kinabileg ti alilaw tapno patyenda ti tiring. Tapno maukong kuma amin dagiti di namati ti pudno no diket nagraywan da ti kinakibot.
All right, in Romans 1:18. Romans chapter 1, verse 18. If you will not love the truth, if you will not believe the truth, God will send you a strong delusion.
Yes.
Since you will not love the Lord and walk your life in His truth, then God will turn you over to a depraved, reprobated mind. He will give you a lie to believe. Because you would not love and believe and walk in the truth.
Gracias.
Forgive me, Lord, for not being always walking in your